Hello, welcome to 15minuteguitar.com. In today's video lesson, we're going to look at the Game of Thrones theme tune. This is going to be premiered on Sky Atlantic on the 15th of April. So we thought with all the excitement going on, it'd be great to teach you how to play the theme. For this one, you're going to need a capo at fret number 3. It's in the key of C minor. I'll probably break it down into sort of its recognisable chord shapes because that you'll make that easier to learn for you. So like there's some A minors, E minors, Fs, Gs, there's quite recognisable chords in here. It's probably the best way to approach this. It starts off with this like minor to major shift. So it starts off on the A minor chord. So if you know your A minor shape, open on the A string, second finger on the second fret of the D string, third finger on the second fret of the G string, and your first finger on the first fret of the B string. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna pick the A string and the high E string at the same time, okay? We're gonna keep this shape on, the A minor shape. So we got, we pick with our thumb, and I'm using my third finger of the right hand. I'm picking those two outside strings, so the A string and the high E string. I pick that, and then I come in with my first finger and I pick the G string, okay, which is already fretted down here with the second fret there on the G. So keep the same shape on. Gonna pick the B string now with my first finger down there, and I'm gonna hammer with my little finger, tricky little bit this, hammer from 1 to 3, and I'm gonna go, so it goes, and then it starts the theme again, so it starts that little cycle. So I'll play it slowly, so. We do that around 4 times, and then we change to the A major shape, okay? This is where I said it goes from minor to major, so it's a really nice sort of lift in the music. The way I approach this is I use my first finger and I move it. It's quite an annoying change, really. You go from that to the major chord, which is that I use my flat finger. Other ways of playing this, but I find it's the easiest way for me to get there. First finger flat across the D, the G, and the B strings, and I'm arching it up. I'm doing some finger aerobics because my little first finger is trying to keep away of the E string because we want to hear that string, so we want to go. So we pick the same again, the A and the outside E string, the high E string. Pick the G string with the first finger of the right hand, and then we're doing this hammer-on thing again where we're picking the B string, and we're hammering from fret 3 where they got the bar to finger 3 on fret 4 of the B, okay? So we've got, sorry, play it right. As you can tell there, you really have to keep that out of the way there, because if I relax that finger like I just did then, it starts to muffle. So you could do it like that. You could use different fingers like that and do it like that, but I just find it easier for me to change from there, so. Okay, and that leads us into the main theme then. So we go back to our A minor chord shape, and then we pick the A and the E string, so we go. Now what we're going to do now throughout this verse is we're going to start pumping this A string with the thumb, just keeping it going, so. This becomes our bass note of the theme, okay? So we got, so we pick the two outside strings, we keep pumping on the A string, and then we pick the G string fret number 2 with our, where we got it covered here with the third finger, so. Then we hammer with our first finger on the B string from 1 to 3. Open E, back to G string, fret 2, which is already covered here. So as you say, if you can keep the chord shapes on, it makes this much, much easier. Okay, so. Then we do hammer again on the B. And then this is where we change our chord to E minor, okay? Finger 2, finger 3, fret 2 of the A and the D strings. And then we go. So now we do the E string and the B strings, okay? And then we do, sorry, we do the E and the B, and then we hit the D string, so. Then we pick the low E and the G string. Use my little finger now to hammer the fret 2 of the G. And then roll to the B open string. Okay, so we put it together what we got so far from the start of the main theme. Thank you. open G there on the end. And then we go to another familiar shape, which is the G chord. Now we do the G, instead of having the little finger maybe on the top of the high E string there, we put that on fret number 3 of the B string. And then we do... So we do the E, low E and the B string together, and we're pumping that E string again, keeping that bass note going. So... So we do two together, so the E and the B, so pump the E, open G, then finger 1 on the B string. We pick off, we pull off to 0. Then we go to fret 3 with the little finger on the B. Open G. And then we go back to the A minor, and we go A minor like that. And we pick the A and the B strings. And then we flick off with our first finger. And then play the G. So put that together slowly, so. We change the shape. We bar our first finger across the D and the G strings at fret number 2, and then we're going to pick the A string and the G string. We pick those together, then the D string, and then we do this little hammer bit from using our second finger, fret 4 to 6 on the D. And at the same time, we're picking the A string, okay? So. Then we return back to the main theme. So we go. That cycle, that fourth theme, so that the main part of the theme, if we call this like section A, this little section, and then section B, which we're going to learn in a second, which got some ever familiar chord shapes, if we learn them separately, so if we learn section A, that's section A there, we're going to do that 3 times with the backing track, and then we're going to go into section B, which is this section now, which I'm going to show you. So this starts with the F major chord, so the F little mini bar chord here with the first finger on the first fret of the B and the E strings. Second finger on the second fret of the G string, and the third finger on the third fret of the D string, okay? I do use my thumb as well over the top, so this is quite complicated. I'm putting my thumb over the top to keep the bass note down there as well, because I'll come to that in a second, so. And I use my little finger as well, so I'm reaching up here, a real stretch. So sorry, I do start with the thumb off and then I put it on later. So little stretch, little finger all the way up to fret number 5 here on the high E string, and then I'm gonna go. I pick the D and the high E strings, then the B, then the G. So we got... and then I change, so... I change to a C major chord, and I put my little finger on the third fret of the high E string, and just do the rundown again, so A and the high E. Then I pick the B and the G, so... Then I go to a D minor chord, so finger 1, fret 1 of the E string, high E, finger 3, fret 3 of the B, and finger 2, fret 2 of the G. So, okay, so we do the D and the high E, B string, G string, and again, and then we go open on the high E string and then hammer the fret 1. So I put that section together slowly, we got... minor. Exactly the same as that intro bit we did, if you remember the A minor intro. Okay, then we go back to F, and we go, this is where the thumb comes over the top. What I'm doing now is I'm picking, with my thumb on the right hand, I'm picking the low E string and the B string, and I'm going those two together, then G string, then the D, and the same again. three times, then to another recognisable chord shape is E7, second finger on the second fret of the A string, open D string, first finger on the first fret of the G string. And I'm doing the E and the B, G, D, same again. And then we go back to the, we just to go back to the A minor shape and we pick the A and the B strings. And then the D, open the D string with the second, well, you've got second finger covering it down this end. And then we go back into that little bar on the second fret of the D and the G. And then we hammer with our second finger on fret four of the D, and then hammer with the little finger, so. Okay, we're hammering from four to six there. And then we go back to the F again, so we do the whole thing again. Second time it comes to the end of the song, and all we do is repeat this little pattern but up an octave. So I'm going to bar my first finger at fret number five on the B and the E strings, so that's five after the capo, and then I'm going to bar that there. I pick the A and the high E, then the B, and then I use my second finger to hammer on six to eight. With the A and the high E strings together. It's a real tricky theme, this one, okay? So it's just nice and fun to play, and you know, you can really practice this and wait for the, you know, wait for the titles to come up in the Game of Thrones as it starts. You get all excited, get your guitar out and have a practice and play along with it. It is a tricky one, so don't feel bad if you can't get this down. Just break it into pieces, try and get section A, which is the first bit with the A minor change, to the A major change, like the intro bit, and then try and get section B down, which is the you know, the bit where it goes to F, and that's the sort of second part of the theme. I hope you enjoy that lesson, guys. It's a tricky one, but we thought it would be a really good one. Seems Game of Thrones is coming out very, very soon. I hope you enjoyed that. I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson.